consecutive chapters, the Lord reveals his plan to give his people a new destiny, a better future. And these promises are ours. They are yours in Jesus' name. It belongs to every individual, belongs to every family, and belongs to the whole church, looking up to God and trusting him for this better future and for this great new beginning. And then as we claim them and stand upon them, these promises and prophecies will be fulfilled upon us as individuals, fulfilled upon us as families, and fulfilled upon us as a whole church. And the Lord is telling us, it is coming. It will come upon your life in Jesus' name. And yet, I need to tell you, we must support that revelation with responsibility. We must support that revelation of the word of God, that I want to do this better thing, better thing, better thing. We must support everything with the responsibility that he gives unto us. And he says, yes, I'm going to do that, but this is what you have to do. I come to point number two now, our responsibility for a better future. Your responsibility, my responsibility, and the responsibility of the whole church for this better future. And I pray that you will live to see the better future. Yeah. You will live to experience the better future. Yeah. And you will live to pass on to your own children this better future in Jesus' name. What then are our responsibilities for this better future? We're looking at Job chapter 11. Job chapter 11. Remember, I'm talking about this now. It is like sowing and reaping. You want to reap? Yes, if you are going to reap, the responsibility is that you are going to sow. Is God that will bring the harvest? Is God that will multiply the harvest? Is God that will bring the rain? Is God that will make all the things we sow to germinate? But we must sow. We must sow. It is a sowing and reaping. We call it cause and effect. The effect is going to be done by the Lord. The result, the reward, is going to be produced by the Lord. But we must be the cause. He says, do this and do this and do this. And then when we do that, then it's going to do its own part. That means then, this is our responsibility, and that is his revelation. And to fulfill that revelation, we have to fulfill our own responsibility. We're looking at Job chapter 11 verse 13. Our responsibility, practical responsibility for a better future. Job chapter 11 verse 13. If thou prepare thine heart and stretch out thine hand toward him, if iniquity be in thine hand, put it far away, and let not wickedness dwell in thy tabernacles. It says that's our responsibility. You cannot say, oh God, I'm here. I want the blessing. I want the revelation to be fulfilled. I want the prophecy fulfill this. There are some people that just do that like parrots. They just knock on the table. Oh God, do it. Oh God, do it. Oh God, do it. Then they say, if I say it 7 times, if I say it 70 times, if I say it 100 times, then by the long, prolonged kind of saying it and saying it and saying it, then something will happen. We have a responsibility, and it says that this is what to do. If iniquity be in your hand, it says, put it far away from you. Only then the blessings will come. Look at this in verse 15. For then shalt thou lift up thy face without spot. Yea, thou shalt be steadfast and shalt not fear, because thou shalt forget thy misery and remember it as waters that pass away. And thine age shall be clearer than the noonday, and thou shalt shine forth, and thou shalt be as the morning. It says, if you will do what we have in verse 13 and verse 14, then it says, the consequence will be the fulfillment of the revelation in your life. And then it says, look at that verse 17 again, and thine age shall be clearer than the noonday, and thou shalt shine forth, and thou shalt be as the morning. Look at verse 18. It says in verse 18, and thou shalt be secure, because there is hope. Yea, thou shalt dig about thee, and thou shalt take thy rest in safety. Responsibility is there. Any sin, any iniquity, any immorality there, get it off. And get it cleansed away from your life, and buy it away from your life permanently, that it will not be again. God knows your heart. He knows your life. We cannot deceive God. We cannot come in here to church and just pretend that everything is okay and dress with January dress and good dress, January dress, and say, now this is covenant month, I dress, I'm so neat, when morally and spiritually things are unclean and undefiled. We must get rid of all that and be clean spiritually and clean morally. And then we can expect the blessings of the Lord. That is our responsibility. Look at Job chapter 22. Job chapter 22 verse 21. Acquaint now thyself with him, and be at peace, thereby good shall come unto thee. Receive, I pray thee, the law from his mouth, and lay up his words in thine heart. If thou return to the Almighty, thou shalt be built up, and thou shalt put iniquity far from thy tabernacles. Do you hear that again? Here Job is telling us over and over and over again that if we're going to get this revelation, prophetic revelation of this better future, if all the showers of blessings are going to fall, and in all those things I read to you about in those seven consecutive chapters of Ezekiel, if they're going to come upon our lives, it says there's something we must do. If there's iniquity there, immorality there, fornication there, adultery there, stealing there, covetousness there, love of money there, which is the root of all evil, put everything away from you, and prostitution there, and all the uncleanness and all the corruption and all the things that the people of the world are doing, and they're still singing that, you know, peace will come, prosperity will come, progress will come, with all those evil things. It says you cannot do that. You know the requirements of the Lord and the responsibility he has placed upon us. Put them far away from you. Look at that again in verse 23. If thou return to the Almighty, thou shalt be built up, thou shalt put away iniquity far from thy tabernacle. Whether people see you or not, whether your pastor is there or not, and whether your husband is there or not, whether your wife is there or not, whether your children are there or not, you put iniquity far away from you. Then he says, here is going to be the consequence and result, because of sowing and reaping, and because of cause and effect, because of responsibility and reward. Look at the result now in verse 24. It says, then shalt thou lay up gold as dust, and the gold of Ophir as the stones of the brooks. Yea, the Almighty shall be thy defense, and thou shalt have plenty of silver. That is, if you put iniquity far away, that's your responsibility. Then it says, the Almighty shall be thy defense. Will you tell me that if you're going to adultery, the Almighty will keep on defending you? You're living in fornication, the Almighty will go on defending you. And you're stealing, you're corrupt, and the Almighty will go on defending. No, you put all that far away, and then the Almighty will come to your defense. And then it says in verse 26, then shalt thou have thy delight in the Almighty, and shall lift up thy face unto God. Thou shalt make thy prayer unto him, and he shall hear thee, and thou shalt pay thy vows. Thou shalt also decree a thing. Thou shalt decree a thing. The word of God says, thou shalt decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. I'm going to personalize this now. Look at verse 28. And I shall also decree a thing.
You have received the message from our pastor, Pastor W.F. Kumuyi, the General Superintendent of the Parallel Bible Church. It is my wish that as you listen, you accept the old word and you will let them sink into your hearts. And by the grace of the Lord, you will never regret it. It is my prayer that by next week, when our pastor shall come up again to present another message, you will be there, your family will be there, and your friends. And I believe as you are listening to the message every week, by the grace of the Lord, you will never be the same. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of today's message. We thank you, O Lord, because of the one you let us listen to last week, and the one we are going to listen to the next week. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, if you tarry, we shall listen together once again next week. And if not, every one of us will be there with you in the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, because you are the Lord that answers prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.